For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Download latest Ubuntu version of iOS file from here. You just have to search Ubuntu 19.04 download, and here is the version. This Disco Dingo is the version name. You just go over here and download this latest image, okay, and click over here and it will download the package. It is 1.9 GB in size, and keep it ready, this ISO image. Then let's continue with the installation.
Like, share, comment and subscribe.
Let's open VMware and click on create virtual machine and click next and click next. Here select the version Ubuntu 64-bit. Next, then give the name, example over here, techarkit-vm, I'm just giving, or Ubuntu 19.04, something like that. You can give any name you can give, and adjust this maybe single or multiple files, and space maybe 20 GB is enough. I'm giving 40 GB over here, and click finish. So VM will be created. Now edit that VM and give that ISO to the mounted to the CD DVD. So this ISO file, just go to the ISO file over here and select that Disco Dingo version, and okay. Now power on the virtual machine, or else just edit again and see. Okay, RAM I have to increase little bit. Now power on the virtual machine. Now virtual machine will be booted with the ISO file. And first screen is loading. It takes some time, first time to adjust the graphics and all this stuff, and it takes little bit time to come up. Now see, so the screen came. Now here you have to select install Ubuntu. And it will ask you for the keyboard language details. Now say what are the language it is. I'm selecting English over here. And now just say if you want to install some third party softwares also, just tick mark over here, third party software installation, and click next. Now select the partition you want. If you want to do a automatic partition, just select erase disk and do creation partitions, but I want to create myself, so that's why select the last option and say disk and say new partition over here, which means that I'm just going to create the new disk. Say okay, create. Now it's going to say blank disk over here. Select this one and click on the plus sign to create more partitions. So now select the free space and click on plus sign. Now provide the space for a slash. So depends on your hard disk size. So I'm just example selecting the space over here, and the file system whatever it is. So in case if you want anything, you can use it. I'm slash is created now. Now select the free space again, click on press sign, and you have to create the boot partition. Maybe it is in between 500 to 800 MB would be good in size, and mount it to boot and click OK. So again, if you want to create the remaining partitions, it's up to you. Like if you want to create some more partitions like mount points, you can create it. Otherwise leave it as it is and just continue with this. But here I'm just going to create some home directories and var and usr for now. So I'm just going to give some 8 GB space over here. That would be enough now. Now I'm going to create one more partition over here. Select the free space, click on plus sign, and provide the space and provide the mount point. That's it. Now if you have more free space, you can create one more partition, or you can continue with the existing one otherwise. Okay, that's it. For now I just created 4 partitions and let's continue with that. And it will ask you whether you want to format with the disk or not. Yes, say yes and next. Now you have to select the time zone, which time zone you want exactly. My time zone is India Kolkata, so select that time zone. And now provide the details over here: username, machine name and password. Anything as per as your wish, but giving this username and password would be, you have to remember it, because after this installation completes, you have to use this password to log in. That's it. Continue with the installation now. I want to change that username to TARKIT. That's it. Now it takes a while to install all the packages to be installed over here. So whatever the packages you have selected, it will be installed all the stuff, and after that it will ask you for the reboot. Until that you have to wait next screen to come up. So now let's wait it and see over here. Now that's it. So reboot this machine, installation completed. It takes a little bit time to reboot. This is the first time loading screen. It takes a little bit time to, because it should adjust the display setting, all the options over here. And now it's rebooting. Almost done. That's it. Ubuntu 19 is installed successfully. If you want to get this full screen, you have to install VMware tools on the VMware, because you may not get by default this much full screen. So in order to do that, you have to install. And let's go ahead and see that about over here, what is the version details, all the stuff. So this is about it, guys. The Dingo is installed successfully. Ubuntu 19.04 we have installed successfully. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.